Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. The August 21st total solar eclipse across America is generating a lot of interest and a lot of questions. You'll find answers to many of your eclipse questions at NASA's Eclipse 2017 website, eclipse2017.nasa.gov. The site is full of information to help you prepare for this rare celestial event, including eclipse-related activities, events, viewing safety tips, and other resources. Then on the day of the eclipse, you can see the event through the eyes of NASA during a special NASA TV broadcast that includes coast-to-coast coverage from the ground, from the air, and from space. Coverage begins with a special pre-show at noon Eastern, followed by in-depth coverage at 1 p.m. You can also watch on August 21st at www.nasa.gov/eclipse-live. The damaged Omni S-band antenna on our tracking and data relay satellite, TDRS-M, has been successfully replaced at Astrotech Space Operations near the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Processing has resumed, and the new target launch date is no earlier than August 18th from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. TDRS-M will join the fleet of Earth-orbiting satellites providing near-constant communication between the ground and spacecraft such as the Hubble Telescope and the International Space Station as part of the space network. The five sun shield layers responsible for protecting the optics and instruments of our James Webb Space Telescope were fully installed recently at NASA industry partner Northrop Grumman Corporation in Redondo Beach, California. The sunshield layers, which are made of Kapton, will help prevent the sun's background heat from interfering with the telescope's infrared sensors. The layers are capable of reducing the temperatures between the hot and cold sides of the observatory by approximately 570 degrees Fahrenheit. Targeted for launch in 2018, Webb is the most powerful space telescope ever built. On August 9th, engineers at our Stennis Space Center conducted another hot fire test of an RS-25 engine flight controller. The objective of the test was to green run or flight certify the engine controller, which is the brain of the engine. Once proven flight worthy, the controller will be installed on an RS-25 engine that will help power the first integrated flight of our Space Launch System rocket with our Orion spacecraft, known as Exploration Mission 1. SLS is designed to power our astronauts deeper into the solar system than ever before. On August 10th, our acting chief technologist, Douglas Terrier, visited industry partner Jacobs near the Johnson Space Center in Houston. While there, he got a first-hand look at some of the more than 100 NASA space exploration projects Jacobs is working on. These include systems for the Orion spacecraft, hardware and engineering services for the International Space Station, and technology development for deep space exploration. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.